Excellent. Hey, 600, how are you doing? Thanks for the host. AOAD. I was going to delay the stream slightly, or rather delay properly starting it, but Discord just came back up, so I was able to quickly notify everyone on there. So, thought to give any extra time for anyone off Discord to hop on. And so we can start. So, yeah, I just tried it now, so I don't know if it got through. Hopefully it did. We'll see, I suppose. Enjoying Gun Cells 2. Excellent, excellent. Glad you're enjoying Gun Cells 2. Just give me a sec. That's a little better. Good stuff. Okay, so I have a couple of what's the playtest this evening. I don't know how long this will take. Again, it might be a short stream, but these were a few that I managed to find. So, again, at this stage, I am just sort of making sure I'm not committed with anything until October starts. So, this will probably be the last stream of the month. Unless I decide to do some filler stuff with WoW Classic, but in terms of other things, I'm gonna be waiting now for I'm gonna get everything set up for October, which is on Tuesday, so not that long to wait really before it all goes into horror month overdrive. Alright, so first WoD of the evening is this one number. By Bobby Zulhead. And it says in the thread, this is the second ever map. I've been working on something a bit bigger to follow up the first map, which was Management Appraisal, which was the one with the office thing that was okay. Wasn't too bad, from what I remember of it. Which looked nice but played a bit meh. But it's taking ages, and I wanted to get something up here. This map took around 2 evenings to pull together, give or take the odd bit of tinkering. It's fairly tough, tight and compact, not sortery, but should keep you on your toes in an ooh, look a rocket launcher, oh shit, I've killed myself kind of way. 3 minutes par, maybe? Good luck. And it's called Corner Compound. Doom 2 vanilla compatible, map 1, tested on GZ Doom 3.6.1, because I haven't updated yet. No jumping, crouching, or looking up. No difficulties implemented. Alright. So, I guess since the newer compatibility, we'll stick with the Doom Strix then for this one. I don't think we have mouse hook enabled from the playthrough of Naivety I completed the other night. So, let's play. Nice custom music. That's what we want to see. And hear, more specifically. Such nice. Huh. I think I put a little thing there, some nice mini detailing there. Guy. I recognize this, but you don't remember where it's from. Possibly the Britonia. Really? God, block map, come on. Yeah, great map. Shit. Jesus, that's why I don't like playing with the newer compound because of the. Let's make the super shotgun not kill pinkies! 1% of the time. Meanwhile, we're. Four cacos. Hey, Scotty, how you doing? Okay now, right? Yeah. Still okay there. Real cute. But now what? Say that mini choice does seem somewhat ill-fitting. What do I go? What am I supposed to do now? I don't know if that's something you get when you go for the blue key area, but or an area of some sort. Why do I have a feeling it has something to do with this door here? Like, you gotta go through the door or something. But it's not, like, working. So I've got Mr. Switch. As far as I can tell, anyway. The friendly Doom playtester. Hey, Enterers, how's it going? I don't know what I'm supposed to do here. Is this lower? Fuck. Before the sleep. Before it's time for bed. Try the door with the default compact setting. Okay. Oh, now it works. So that's real great. He tested it without... He said he wants it to be vanilla combat, but... It doesn't actually work. It's as such. So that's not vanilla compatibility, because otherwise I'd be able to use that on Doom Strix. Now I have to leave it on this other one. I mean, you might want to set your compatibility rating. I would think that might be something that... Playtest is what Shark would do. I see vanilla compatibility and I think I gotta play this in a... position of the chain gun. I don't like the berserk being on the pickup there. So I really don't like that berserk being a forced pickup for me. Honestly. So bad. Yeesh. Nice exit room. Oh, real life stuff intervened with Alper. Hopefully the real life stuff will allow you to come back afterwards. Hopefully. Okay, so that was Bobby Zulhead's corner compound. Vanilla compatible, hopefully. Well, no, not at all, actually. That's my first criticism. I'm going to start using compatibilities to gauge how people are mapping. It's not vanilla compatible. I had to play this with the default DZ Doom settings. So, you know, that's an issue. I mean, if that issue occurs in PR Boom and they don't have a fix at all and you just have a stuck door... But that seems like something you should really fix. I wonder if anyone has actually noticed that. Someone played it.
We have three looks and it noticed. Oh,
I really noticed that door. PR does have a function. Well, that's the first thing. They need to make sure that door works. I mean, it looks like the only person who responded was playing us in GZ Doom. So that's something like Choco, yeah, be out of luck. I mean, it says it's vanilla compatible, that's the thing. So you assume that when you say something like that, you are obviously aware of the compatibility settings. I mean, the fact I had to change compatibility settings from what is deemed the vanilla to a Zedumi default, you know, that's just confusing. Hey, Terelli, it's going good, it's going good. I'm just playtesting as I do. This is probably going to be the last, what I would call a meaningful stream before October, around the corner. They probably mapped in vanilla format, but only tested in Zedum. Well, yeah. I mean, again, you know, I hope that somebody, if they do choose to playtest this WOD, and I will link it again, hopefully someone plays it in PR Boom and sees the same error comes up. And if so, that's a bit more of a glaring problem there. I mean, I remember when I was a mapper, I had to be told that I had to test with Infinite Height on because people were playing PR Boom on vanilla settings. And I hated doing that, but it was a thing that had to be considered, you know? I mean, you do see that with some people. They stick with GZ Doom and don't account for
Infinite Height or vice versa.
You probably get people who only map in PR Boom and don't account for people who don't use Infinite Height. Especially, which is why you gotta set out your settings very clearly, you know. Pistol Star or Continuous. What settings did you use? What the hell? So, yeah. Other than that, though, the map itself seemed fine. I wasn't happy with the Berserk pickup on the, I wasn't happy with the Berserk pickup for that fight. I mean, I just don't like it when you have to, I mean, there didn't seem to be any real use for the Berserk. And I just don't like being forced into pickups like that unless there's a fight that's going to use it very specifically.
Oh.
You got to Radiant Map 12, 32. Didn't use PR Boom, so be it shot me hundreds of vanilla hours in struggle with PR Boom, which is more than 12 hours long. God. Not today. So, you know, it was a pretty decent map on the whole. It just didn't like that Berserk and, again, that door. So, that's what's to be worked on. All right. So next up, we have this one, which is called this, strangely enough. And this is by Raccoon, I guess. Hey, Mikey Dude, how you doing? They say the Fred, first map that I've made that's beatable. I know it kind of sucks, but I think it was fun to test. And that's it, there's no files or anything. And then someone says below, a tiny laser rifle and an SSG slaughter fest. The switch texture at the end sums it all up. Yeah, also the avatar is fuck. So, I'm just checking. I don't think it's being compared to D-Zone. And, alright then. No! No! Oh yes, you are still a subscriber, you can use that emote. Isn't it great to be able to say, don't you try and pass off your inferior, globally approved Twitch things, Mikey Dude. Mine is better. Because it just looks nice. Great. So, okay, this may well be a map. We will see. Find out, shall we? This is a good start. Star tan everywhere. Man, at least we have some curved walls. Okay. Oh god. And thank you for the follow, Alyssa_Skyor. No. Got red problems. Yeah, he killed him. Oh, they're all dead. That wasn't too hard then. Okay. Sure. That's it. Okay. That appears to be the map. I don't know if someone said it was an SSG Swarfest when it is a plasma gun provided, but shades of maximum doom. So are these inescapable? Yeah, these are inescapable bits. So this is really the first map that was beatable, huh? It's a simple enough idea. Just needs more complexity to it. Like, maybe it could be cool if, like, you went over here and this wasn't the exit, and then you had to go all the way back to the start, but then things go in the way, like obstacles or more enemies, you know. Maybe, like, you can't use some of the pit ways, like some walls rise up and you gotta go around a certain route, but then a whole bunch of stuff gets thrown in. You know, for such a simple room, you could do some stuff with it if you wanted to. But as it turns out, just do that. Which is, in fact, what is stopping me from just going... And I'll see you all on Doom Speed Demos for my 7-second run. No resistance. Never a good sign when that is an option in your map. You can just speed run to the exit in a few seconds. I didn't even SR50. Nope, I didn't do anything.
So that was that by Raccoon, I guess. What did we think of that?
Beatable map. That's all. Nice map. Glad you enjoyed it. If you want to play, I did just link it before. A lot. There's a lot to do. If you want to stick with the simple room ideas, that's fine, but you need to do more with these simple rooms, like add different textures. He did use some green wall texture. Okay, add some extra stuff, like make the singular room last longer kind of thing, you know. Have more obstacles.
Yeah, you could put two arch valves,
right? You could press the switch and then a bunch of walls raise up and you have to walk around in a sort of curved S shape and some arch valves could resurrect some stuff. I mean, there's enough plasma and super shotgun ammo there for there to be a lot more to fight, really. I mean, that's the kind of map that a speed map could be done in a speed map in like 10 minutes, probably. But I'm just saying, you know, Raccoon, if you're going to do some more mapping, then you should add more complexity. Even to just a simple room like that, you know, add more complexity to it. $400 revenants. Well, you can do that, Scotty, and then you can release it, and then you'll see if it's better with $400 revenants. I mean, I don't think 400 revs would work, though. There's no cover, you know. It'd just be a clusterfuck. It'd just be 400 revs powering around limited space and a lot of plasma. You couldn't just have it like that with 400 revs in it. It just wouldn't work, Scotty. And you know it wouldn't work. Maybe you're talking to Godspeed at the start, perhaps, but the idea is to bum rush your way through the revs as fast as possible before it runs out. Hey! Okay, now you're just getting silly. This is what happens. Scotty makes a comment and then people get silly. It's like you're the initiator. That's not the word. The enabler of revenants and silly comments. All right. So, moving on. God, I might be done with this stream in another hour. But that's fine. These all sound like things that I've heard of before. Okay, so the next map is this one by, I feel I need to put the light on in my room actually, Maximanium, with a map which I think is just called Axis. Yeah, I think it's just called Axis. That's what it's called. Alright. Just gonna turn the lights on. It is a bit dark in here. It is dark. It is what it is, you know? So, welcome back, Alper. Welcome back to the third map of the evening. You don't miss too much so far. I actually only have 5 maps of playtesting and I've lined up. Oh no, a what posted yesterday that John contests if he runs out of maps. Hey folks, Maximanium says, I finally worked up the courage to ask for feedback for my first level. It's pretty short and it probably won't knock your socks off. I first made it about a year ago, forgot about it, and then came back to it recently.
Posting it.
Adding finishing touches and changing the balance. This is vanilla compatible. I use Crispy Doom for playtesting, it runs in Chocolate Doom as well, but this Pain Explorer says there are a few spots with draw segs overflows. Nonetheless, I don't see any harms. I have implemented difficulty settings in this map as well. I tried to make it challenging but fair. Try solo net. Whatever that is. I also have secrets in Doom level, so naturally my map has them as well. Keep your eyes peeled, though they shouldn't be difficult to find. Any feedback or constructive criticism would be much appreciated. I don't have much creative drive, but I'm hoping I can include this as the first of a 5-level Doom 2 episode, our Scythe 2. And then there's something like, while I'm at it, what is the code of conduct for using MIDIs that aren't yours? I grabbed the one in this one from a website containing a plethora of MIDI sequence from video games. The author is listed in the metadata in Slade, but I assume it would at least need to be credited in the accompanying text file, right? Thanks in advance. I'd imagine you'd probably have to mention where you got it from. Yes, that would probably be a thing. Yeah, I actually used vanilla for it, so now we can put this on Doom Strictly. Apparently. Are you sure this is a Green Day Mini? It sounds a bit like Sonic Adventure. Or a Sonic song. Possibly. I don't know the words to this song, but I'm gonna try them anyway. Oh my, oh god, there's a female. Press, press, press. Oh god, I need to use a chainsaw a shit ton. Vanilla chainsaw as well. Yes. Go down, creep. Oh, that's the end of the level. Sounds like a Green Day song. Yeah, I was going to say, it sounded very much like Sonic Adventure 2. That one song that was everyone likes and stuff. Alright, that's the end of the level. Right, so, what do we all think of that one? A bit more effort put into that one than the previous one, I suspect. So, yeah, for someone's first level, I wasn't too bad. Should have got to use a chainsaw a lot. That point makes more sense as part of an episode rather than standalone. Well, that's the intention. So, yeah, as an opening map, that would be alright, I think. The elf notes in the mini drove you insane. They drove you mad. They made you want to do something. So I look forward to seeing more maps from this planned episode of yours, Max Manium. I don't know what the answer to that MIDI question is, though. I guess I'd imagine you'd have to credit people and the correct authors of MIDI files in your text files. I think that's what most people do. The only reason they usually don't is because they sometimes don't know where they got it from, but I'd imagine that people would probably credit MIDI files as appropriate, because otherwise they'll be asked, where did you get that MIDI from? So, yeah. Not bad. Okay, so next up we have this one by Lucas. I think to put the version there because he did actually update this. I think it's meant to be 1.1, but that's not what the WAD's called, so I'm going off the WAD name there a little bit. So this is Gibbous version 1.1, the first level by Lucas. Just create the MIDI orphan if it's MIDI conversions of the original source as well. Alright. Well, that'll be useful information for Max Manium for the future. They may have been answering the thread or not. I didn't actually look at the whole thing. So, Lucas says, I feel like I've done alright in terms of gameplay, but I don't know where to start with visuals. Feels fairly bland. Gameplay-wise, I think it is too look-dependent. What do you guys think? Personal best, 22 seconds Ultra Violence, and same on Nightmare. 30 seconds is a par. Edit. I forgot to mention what I'm aiming for in terms of gameplay. I want this level to be a fast level going forward. I want this level to be a fast level going towards the switch to open the exit door and a more careful level going back to the exit. I intentionally made ammo scarce and health noises and ultraviolence and nightmare. I think hurt me pointing maybe too close to ultraviolence and difficulty. Edit 2. I just realized how much I stuck with texture alignment. Some of those issues have been fixed in the new zip file. Edit 3. Somehow I didn't add the correct version. Now it's actually possible to hit par time. Update to the map 1.1. Made the initial dash to the left look base by hiding many of the demons behind closets. New personal best on Nightmare. Okay, so we got a bit of a fast-paced, gimmicky type map, I guess. You actually played this one. Okay. 1% health in a dream. Well, chain gunners probably aren't going to make things any. I think it might be argued that you do have to speed run this one. Oh god damn, play him get off the damn lift. Oh for fuck's sake. Your work in progress level. Oh god, I can actually see the top of the wall there in the closets. Wait, where are the other monsters then? Oh my god, I found the secrets! Oh no, I'm stuck! I can't get out! Why is the water not sectioned off? Wait, where are the other enemies then? Two enemies here, I get that. But then what? I'm so confused. The second secret. Another 1 HP mirror. Well, that was already done, unless there's like. And there has to be an extra room full of enemies. Because. There's still 12 enemies on the map somewhere. So I'm trying to find where it is. Where is this secret? Wait, what am I on here? Apparently this wall opened. Well, this is where the teleports came in, right? Oh no, wait, no, there are enemies back there. What the fuck? Oh, that's why they didn't come in. I was silent in this room. I see. Damn it! Okay, at least we know where they are now. So, alright. So that was the level. I killed them all without dying. So that was that by Lucas. An interesting map. Yes, you must practice Extreme Worlds. I tell you. You must not. You must always. You must never give up. You know, the first map you will make will probably will be terrible most of the time. But the only way you're going to get better is to submit that map for feedback. For other people to gauge. And then you can figure out where to go from there. You know, as I've said before. Plenty of other mappers' first maps were terrible too. They all had to start from somewhere. So, an interesting idea for a map, I have to say. Seems like you can completely, well, I guess I would have normally not triggered that, but hey, a speedrun strategy helps you skip one fight. Hello, Lucifer Sap. How you doing? But it's nice that you had an idea for a map, right? A gimmicky idea that kind of paid off a bit. So this map has seemed like you wanted to improve the looks of the maps. Well, yeah, there were some things with the closets. You could see the top end of the raised wall, which I guess has to be hidden better. The rooms could have a bit more complex in terms of height, lighting, and prop usage, I guess. But it seemed okay, map-wise, I think. I'm pretty good. I'm updating my house network. New switch, new stuff. Oh, I see. I hope it works out for you. Alright. Wow, I'm onto the last map of my current set already. Tennis is going to be a short stream, but I didn't think it'd be under an hour. Unless this one is the longest yet. Which it could be. It could be the longest yet. You don't know. Okay, so last up we have this one. This is by Kuro Maho and it's called Some Evil Fortress. I myself don't know how you make that master look good, but having interesting looking stuff can help. Looking good is subjective. Yeah, it is. It's a variety of factors, you know. It's like having good lighting variation, texture variation, height variation, building up a good set of textures to build a theme to a room, etc., etc., you know. Again, these are all picked from the forums, Antares. I do get the occasional request, but most of the time, this is me browsing WADs and mods, looking for, like, almost looking for, like, first map type deals. And stuff I just want to play and pick out, so. Mind if you make a suggestion? Well, what's that? Anyway, after we'll see how I feel after this. First, so I made my first WAD. It's called Some Evil Fortress. Oh, you got all right. Okay. Oh, sweet. This is a perfect one. Yes, very good. Alright, cool. What? Otex texture pack? Yo. Yeah, I'll take a look at it afterwards. Thanks, Enteris. That will be a nice one to add. To the thing. Very helpful. So anyway, on to this one. Kuro Maho. So I made my first war. It's called Some Evil Fortress. It's not that great. Some glitchy textures on the doors. But it's playable. It'll need Doom 2 to replace this map 1. This is best played with GZ Doom and there is no platforming. Alright, sure. Someone asks,
what engines and stuff? GZ Doom to test.
Okay. Okay, fine. This looks good too. Sure. Right. Back to this one. I want that one as well. Thank you, Scotty. Door texture looks a bit weird here, doesn't it? Oh God! We don't want no sensation. Where's the key thing? The ammo was everywhere. Oh God. The texturing is... Ah, what? Ah, there's a missing texture of some sort here. But it's not... That is weird. You can see how I'm supposed to look on the other side, but oh, only size doors. Free Soul Sphere, sure. No, no, you're just a brick in the wall. Oh no, you're just another wall texture on the wall. God, the star tan is really weird looking here. Crater is so... That looks so weird. Doors are... This room is the most complex looking room, and it... The exit switch? What's down here then? There's a cyber demon down here. But he doesn't appear. What? Why is the cyber demon not appearing? I thought I had a cyber demon, and I thought, no, surely not. What are these other two enemies? Yeah, it's not an illusion pit, so it can't be. There's two more enemies I've somehow missed. What the hell have I missed here? Oh, there's an extra closet earlier back in the level. Oh, we know you're just another fire tanks on the wall. Not a secret. That's not a secret, is it? Wait, this door isn't opening. What? A one-time use only door? On both sides? That one's fine. Non-repeatable doors. And this cyber demon is stuck in this pit. I could jump over him. What can you do about it? Oh no, you're just stuck in an inescapable pit. Yeah. It certainly is another brick in the wall. So, that was a map. What do we all think of that by Kuro Maher? The texturing was so off. Non-repeatable doors. A cyber demon stuck in a pit but can't do anything. Unless you're trying to scare players off with noises. An unkey marked door. A secret, but it's not a secret. It should have been marked as a secret. Tip for using doors in toilets: put an overhang above to make them look right. Preferably by making them look like they are set in the wall. Yeah, that does help. It actually needs a lot of work, yeah. Yeah, it looks... I like the... Oh, I don't have yawning so much tonight. The room before the red key was quite nice looking, but then it was just a messed up sort of platform. You know, it was all off. And then nothing happened when I got the key. Like, that was the kind of room where you could have had enemies appear in it as well. Right in that big grey room. That was a good room to have enemies. But then, why is there a cyber demon in a pit? I don't get that. Is it supposed to rise up from the pit, or are you really supposed to just leave it down there as well? If you fall down here, well, this is your punishment. The mini choice was also a thing. Can't say I point him out and think of Pink Floyd, but wasn't D running. Yeah, I wish there's no way of killing that cyber demon down there.
Well, there's a way to bring it up.
Well, you get a god spear, but then how do you get out of the pit? Most people, yeah, that's why some mappers might have teleports back to earlier areas for UV maxes and people who just want to kill everything to satisfy the percentile bloodlust, as it were. So, a lot of things to work on, but a lot of things to work on, just in general. Right, well now I need to go and download these two additional maps I've been given. So do bear with me while I do that. Apparently I'm going to need a texture pack for this first one. Yeah, just give me the download. Then go back to the Freya, because I need to download the Eltex pack, apparently. Wait, didn't I... Excuse me. Did I not fucking download Eltex? Oh no, I have version 0.9, but I don't think I have version 1.0. Oh my god. Okay, at least I don't think I had version 1.0. I could be wrong though. So whatever. Eltex! We're gonna see some motherfucking Eltex and shit. It's gonna be great. Alright, let's dump these in a folder. Just bear with me, everyone, while I sort of sort this out as fast as possible. Head back to the thread. Put these here and splash it. Oh god, okay. Give me that. Okay, yeah. And while I'm here, I think I'll have Eltex as a folder on its own, to be honest. Because I think I'll be using it quite a lot in the future. Just got a feeling I might be using a lot more Eltex in the future. So, yeah. Give it a bat. Alright. Okay. Now I think we're just about ready to get this party started. And on the 1 hour mark exactly, I'm able to start. And thank you for the raid, A. Mackert. How are you doing? And now I will link the thread. Hope you had a good stream. Currently on the 6th map of playtesting this evening. I was done with 5, but what do you know, some of my viewers had some stuff for me to cover, and so I'm covering it now. And we're going to get to see some Eltex. How? Yes, I've already played Eve Eternity. Yes, I played it and I loved it. I love the texturing of it, and that's why I was really hyped for Eltex. And it looks like people are very slowly beginning to use it, of which there'll be a giant dam opening up now that version 1.0 is out. I expect a lot of people will start using Eltex in both amateur and professional projects. Yep. Plenty of dogs using Eltex. You know, it might be a bit rough, but I'm sure their mats will pack more bark than bite. So this is Chimera Station by Dak. A first map. Alright, I can do this. I will do this. Here goes. To resume a long story, I decided to sit down and create a map one day. A small one, with strict area constraints, just to get something out there. I got way further into it than previous efforts, then I got burnt out, took a break, came back, and got even further than the previous fervor. Today I decided I was done shifting sectors and objects, and it was time to tie a nice bow on the map and make it public. So, without further ado, Chimera Station. A very small map for Doom 2. Get the key, open the gate, and be ready for a fight. Requires a boom-compatible source port. Tested with both GZ Doom 4.2 and PR Boom Plus. And all of Bojoing's Eltex Texture Pack. Which I guess is Yukiro's name. Get it here. There are difficulties setting implemented. Not sure how to grade them well with well-known map sets, but it should not be too sunderish on ultra-violence. Don't worry, Dak. I don't think it's sunderish, because if it was sunderish, your map would have about 9,000 enemies and take about 6 days to complete, or 6 hours. No, I didn't... I played it... Because of the lack of Eltex? No, I played it because I was hyped about this Eltex, and, you know, it was something I was... I mean, I wasn't actually originally going to bother with Eve Eternity, but I didn't. But everyone wanted me to play it, and I said, screw it, I'll see it, and I'm glad I did. And Eltex is great, and I can't wait to see a lot more of it. So... Hey, Dave. Twitch isn't dying, by the way, Dave. despite your tweet about it. So here we go. Let's play. Okay, there's that bright, sunny gate thing with an invisible wall blocking it off. This is currently the 6th one, Dave. We've had a lot of short ones. AMTX, yep. OTEX. It looks nice. Did I see a... I thought I saw something out there for some reason. Yeah, it's been a lot of short maps though. So I've got this one and then a one over. Where'd the Mancubus go? Got a nice little wood theme going on here as well. Wood, stone, and a big ass void. Hello, Purple Nerd 23. What is your serious question? What that off. Me. This escalated quickly. Like, really quickly. Holy shit. Oh, Jesus Christ. Wow, real fucking nice. I have no health for most of the fucking level, and now... Oh, that helps, actually. I guess. Yeah, we go from this to... Oh. Keep in mind, I started the level with 3 shotgunners. Guess that Mega Armor might help a little bit, but Jesus. Pepsi or a Coke guy? I mainly drink water. I'm not really fussed between them. Mega Armor will help eventually. Ow! god. Doesn't really help that fucking much. Still way... Ah, lost souls everywhere. Your own damn hole. Get out of the fucking way, you fucking cunt. Fuck you. Also, fuck you. Fuck off. Fuck off, man. Jesus. Look at the Lossos came flying out of the gate. That was kind of cool. Why does Doom Guy drop all his keys at the end of each level? Maybe it's like the tax you have to pay for teleporting into a level quickly. You personally didn't get the hype for Otex. Alright. Well, not out of the woods just yet, but... Ah! No! There we go. Again, I will state that the Mega Armor was really handy, Chief. Really near that Mega Armor. My least favorite enemy? Take a wild guess. I'll give you a clue. You're seeing about seven or eight of them right now. Oh god, there's more of them! Ha! Ah. Choke on that, you flying bastards. What souls? I mean, they can be annoying sometimes, but no. Revenants. Purple nerd. Revenants. Really don't like Revenants. At all. Yeah, they are like mosquitoes. And occasionally there's something that spits out mosquitoes. Which makes it really bad. I was gonna say just the same thing on both sides, but no. We have Revenants and Cacodemons. Interesting. Oh wait, more Lossos. Okay. Oh god, there's a Rev Rocket trying to chase after me. Scary. Nice. I'm one down. Will you go away, please? There you go. Fuck's sake. Are you fucking kidding me? God fucking damn it. I make it so fucking close. I get screwed over at the last minute. Ah, it's pissed me off that. Yeah, real fucking stingy on health. Well, I used all the health. The real problem was the lack of health before this fight. Fuck off. There's not enough fucking health in this, I'd agree. But the main problem is that you get no health at the beginning of this fucking area. This fucking area. You fight 3 hit scans and your only health is about 40-45%. Which you're then expected to carry over into this fight, where there's Revs, Mancubus, and all kinds of stuff. Not even a Mega Spear, I think just the beginning is just... I mean, the fight idea is fine, I guess. When your rockets get used here, but... Yeah, they are like mosquitoes. You just can't get rid of them. Yeah, this was mapped by somebody called Dak. Who mapped this? Me? Dak. Yeah. Up there. You see? There. That. At the top. That is where you go if you want the information in the mapper during my playtests. Also, when I link them in the description. That is where you go. Seems like something you'd make. Guess you'll never know if I killed him or not. The fact that the only form of armor is hidden is a secret. So... yeah. The Otex use was nice. Can you submit a level? Well, if you post it up on Doomworld, then yes, you can. I would generally recommend that anyway. You know, post it on Wads and Mods, and there are several other people who will play your play stuff. If I don't cover it, someone else will. So a few active playtesters these days. E1-DM2 is not a particularly good song for a map since it works for a more calm level. Yeah, the music choice was... it was off, but it wasn't, like, detrimental, really. Now, my main problem is that... this map is you start the level with this. 1, 2, 3 shotgun guys. Your maximum health accumulation on this level, as far as I can... gauge is 3 shotgun guys, right? That's where you get your shotgun from. Followed by 3 more shotgun guys. Then, okay, yeah, armor 4, 5, 6. So, there is, in total, 45% health and 6 armor to recover from. Then you go over here, I guess. Then there's another 10%, 55, 9% armor, 50, 61%. So you get 61% health after dealing with 6 hits seven, eight, several hit scanners plus other stuff. To then have to deal with Revs, Mancubus, and what's else coming from behind. Like, what's the best case scenario I can expect here? Probably something like that, but that's like a best case scenario, really. I think. Also, there's another few down here as well. Yeah, I mean, I did better that time, but there is a possibility that your survival ability, where you need to move forward to get extra health, will depend on how you do in the first bit of the level. There's something about that I just don't like, really. I mean, it's like a first-time trap almost, where it's like, okay, so there's not going to be much health, so I need to be a lot more careful early on so I can survive. And yeah, the armor is... There is no armor unless you go to the secret. Perhaps in the courtyard, there should be some armor to encourage the player to go towards it, and then you can sort of get them moving around. Because the maneuverability of the rest of the fight is fine, and I do like that you walk off the areas and you put Lost Souls through the gate and generally how it plays out. But there is really that lack of health and armor unless you get lucky with the secret. Just seems stingy to me. Like, it's off just a little bit. But apart from that, the courtyard is nice and the Eltex use was pretty good. The music could be a bit different, perhaps, but yeah, it seems alright for a first map. No, Dave, there needs to be more. I mean, the Mega Armor is more than enough, but it's in the secret. I would perhaps agree, maybe a Mega Armor in the courtyard, then a Soul Spear, and that could be it, or something. Something to drag the player forward. E3M2 would have been a great song. Yeah, E3M2 might have been a little better. But yeah, okay. But nice to see that map there. Alright. Oh, I need to download this one. Alright, give me a second. Let me download this final one. This should be interesting. I like that in the description of this thread. Let me just grab that quick. Sorry about this, everyone. I'll need to be a moment. Ooh, we have a custom thing for this one. Okay. Coolio. So, this final one for tonight is by underscore sync and is called Architecture and Mortality. It's an interesting name. I guess I can close that now. So, we do actually have a nice custom screen here, which hopefully is showing up. So, Architecture and Mortality is a Doom-compatible free map set for Doom 2 with new graphics and music by me. Tested primarily with Eternity. Oh, hey, there you go. Someone who uses Eternity. As well as PR Boom Plus and GZ Doom. Easy to medium difficulty. Third level takes a lot of inspiration from Plutonia. Then we have some screenshots. The level design was primarily inspired by my recent experience traversing airports. That is what they say. Traversing airports. We'll set the combat to boom strict. So, airports inspired doom mapping. Who'd have thought? I don't know. That is... What is this supposed to be? Like a bunch of scratch marks? Or a... This is a very strange picture. Airport doom. Air doom. It's like a very weird compressed picture with... I don't know. Is this like a vaporwave type effect or something? Well, here we are. Three maps in this as well, by the way. It's a window that's broken, leading to a weird... Good work, Imp. You get the gold star. Yeah, I haven't been to an airport for ages too. And it probably will be ages until I go to another one. Where's that chain gonna go? There we go. Definitely fear of heights. Yeah, same here, man, but I don't mind going on an airplane. Airplane is fine. If I want more than 4 feet from the ground, I get nauseated. Guess that's a secret. If you have to fly to it, ain't worth going to see. Okay. So does that mean if you jump up in the air you get nauseated then or something? Some really nice architecture in this so far, and lighting. As you'd expect from a ward that is called Architecture and Mortality. I guess you'd expect it to have some nice architecture. And dead stuff. Come on! Really, dude? Oh, nice block map again. VR. I don't plan on getting VR. At the moment, VR sounds like an expensive luxury that hasn't quite fully come to fruition yet. It's quite a thing here too. Looks like this was a very good suggestion of yours, Scotty. Sweet Pea, you need more exercises. No more video games. I love this game. You're gonna play a bit of Son of Your Cousin's VR headset when he's down. Boy, was it a trip. I imagine Sunday would work really well with, VR. Grand Procaster, I don't even know where to start with that state sentence of yours. I need more exercises, no more video games. I've been to the gym 3 times this week. For the 3rd week in a row. I am doing exercises, I can assure you. Oh, VR. Nothing in this room. Okay, sure. Oh, okay. I could kind of see now it's more windows and odd shots. It's just this weird compression of the whatever picture this is, and this artsy whatever it is, very pixelated. So how much of that was like an airport? Maybe a little bit. Maybe. Now I'm going to weigh myself tomorrow. Hopefully I've lost a bit more weight. I've done pretty well actually recently. Ever since I came off drinking, funnily enough. Map 2. Definitely not Heathrow. You lost 3 pounds this week. Well done to you, Dave. I've lost 2 pounds in the last 2 weeks. So I'm getting there. Oh, is that to be pistol started, I wonder? Yeah, I'll just stay continuous. Fuck it. I like these lights. Thank you. You're pretty strict on yourself, though. Sometimes you have to be strict on yourself, though. I know I have to try to be strict, because I... Oh yeah. Very nice design of SWAT so far. I sense this might not be the first thing that Sync has ever created. Yeah, 400 quid for a VR setup and there's not that many games for it at the moment. The only good VR game I've seen so far is Beat Saber. Yeah, that game looks pretty fun, and there's a lot of custom stuff you can add to it as well. So it's kind of like this, the next generation of DDR style, the exercise style game, as you could call it, I guess. The music in this world is also pretty decent. It's very low-key funky. You do like your instant closet traps, don't you, Sync? That's a nice touch, a little side vent, as it were. I don't actually know. Doesn't actually say what the MIDI is from, so I don't know. I don't think it's a MIDI bug, yeah. Yeah, it's very low-key, whatever it is. Yeah, it's nice. Again, I kind of see in some aspects how it's inspired by airport architecture. Very slight. I'm not describing it very well. Not so much here, though. So remember, Doom Mappers, you can be inspired by the world you live in. Go to an airport, a bus station, you know, even the pub. Make a map of your pub. Yeah, people still do that today. You don't have to necessarily make it all the same place. You just have to... You could always be inspired by it. Okay. Fake wall there, sure. Alright. This is very low-key trance, sort of. Not too overpowering or anything. Sounds like we're gonna have to go down there. Hopefully it's a very short journey. Smart move, Resident. Smart move. Demons are not known for their intellect. They are known for their barbaric ruthlessness. Dormant tag in GZ Doom Builder makes mobs invulnerable. Though I guess it also means they don't attack the player or anything. Hence dormant, right? Oh boy, this escalated quickly. There's a way to make mobs invincible in GZ Doom Builder. Didn't know that was a thing. No, Scotty, you can't use that tag. Yeah, it's like when you have them in cages and stuff, some really weird fancy effects and stuff. Yeah, my house dot war was also a thing. I don't know what, you know. I still remember that one that people made of the one of the English campuses. You know, people will make all sorts of stuff. Ah, this way is now open for business. I guess you get enough health to survive that, but still a forced run through a pain sector for a little bit. I was gonna say nice progression here, but that's actually the wrong way. Now you must go all the way back to here. That's it. You idiot gave you PTSD, I'm not surprised. So, that was Architecture and Morality by Sync. What do we all think of that wad? I like that. That was very nice. It was not too difficult, but I liked the architecture and the lighting, and the music was a nice sort of low-key-ish choice. There were no planes. Can I recommend a P-Wad that's in Alpha? Looks like a nice, yeah, nice little map set of three. Inspired by airport visits. And I can kind of see that in them. A P-Wad that's in Alpha? I'm not taking, like, WAD requests of that nature, Paper Nerd 23. I mean, it depends how long it is, I guess. If it's going to be, like, a full megawad of stuff, then... That would be like practically a like a project playthrough, really. I tend to like playing a lot of shorter maps with the playtest so I can cover. Oh, it's just two maps? Okay. Do you have a link then in that case? And I'll have a look. But yeah, I thought that was pretty good. By Sync. I actually only registered this year, so if they have been doing stuff before, then Oh, it's your map back. Okay. Well, sure. All right. I mean, I guess I got time. Don't hear a quack. Of course I have time. But yeah, I need a wink. I'm going to play it. So, good stuff. By Sync. Hey, Austin A. Doom. This was about to be the end of the stream, but Purple Nerd 23 has something I need to test, so I'm just waiting to get a wink. Yeah, a lot of smaller things playtested tonight. Again, I'm not really committing to anything until October now. I don't want to, like, get dragged into anything. You know, once October starts, it's pretty much horror stuff go. Alright, so we have a link. Great. Oh, thanks, Purple Nerd. You've extended the torture. I'll just call this a whip. Alright. So we will be continuing for one more map. You say map 21 info has more maps, the game is 3 degrees below. God, how many maps is this? Why, is it just two maps or... Three degrees below zero. Oh, two maps you want me to play. Okay. That's fine. I'll play these two maps then. Sure. So, what maps am I playing then in that case? Okay, so it's... I see. So, there's a lot of maps still to be done. And there's only... So, map 20. Okay, so... Yeah, I can see this stuff to be done. All right. Oh, okay. All the weapons, including a pistol. It's a boss fight. Right. What? Wait, how do I attack this thing? Now, the platform's not high enough, is it? Oh, it is. Okay. What? I thought that was too low down. That's why I didn't shoot it at first. Shoot it in its ugly face! The easiest icon of sin ever. Don't change a thing. Change nothing. It's perfect. Dave, it's a different world. We're not talking about planes and airports now. That was brief. I guess 21's the other one, right? Yep, 21 it is. what you want, now it's Plains. So I guess we're in hell now. Yep. So you are following traditional... I can see the sky texture wrap around it, so... That looks flat. Yeah, that's a very flat texture there. Too late, there was a revenant. It seems a bit weird that the lava only goes so far off into the distance. Stretch those sectors out. Wait a minute, I can't escape this way. Oh no. Oh, so it's because I'm supposed to get the red key card is why. Weird. It's supposed to be out of sight. I can't even get up there, so... Weird. Yeah, I see the secret, but I can't get up there anyway. Take the lava path. I can't get up there, though. That's the weird thing. There isn't any way to get up there. Like, at all. Oh yeah, I found a secret. And another secret. Hey there, hope okay. Yep, it sure does. Thankfully, there's a teleport. Wait, what? Teleport doesn't work! Ah! Yeah, it's dumb. Hmm. It looks like it's still very much a work in progress, I would say. First map. Well, it's the first map you did for this project. Nah, it's just map 22. Okay. I mean, there's a map 1, but... Whoa, holy crap, look at the size of the stretching. And a very weird invisible wall, but I guess maybe this is going to be more fleshed out later, but look at the size of this room. Wait, why did I suddenly go a lot further into it than I had previously thought possible? That was because four chain guns. Okay, well, this is cool, but... it looks really empty like this. Like, am I supposed to have run the length of a desert or something to get here? Honestly though, I'd put a secret out here, just... You're on Pluto. Oh, okay, so this is like the planet's surface then. I'd actually put a secret out here. Let the player actually go out into the middle of this one, like... Put some kind of weird secret or something. It's like a serious Sam-esque secret situation right there. Ceiling is untextured. It's also a bit weird when you see that coming in like that. Randomly placed. Call back to E1M1. Oh, and there's another level. Thank you. Get everything back. It's just a whole level, huh? What? The fuck? Is that supposed to be a lift that goes up? I guess so, but I see a switch. I assume that. Yeah, that is. What? Built up for a cyber demon in a cage. Don't kill it. Run for the exit. But you give so much plasma ammo. I killed it. Also, no texture on the side. Weird, trippy effects thing. That was a crate room. It's a crate room. How many more of these levels are there? Well, I think at this point I kind of get the picture. This needs a bit more work. Three. There are three more levels. Alright. Ah. Alright, well, I guess we can keep going then. I mean, I guess a lot of this is missing textures. It's down to the fact these are still very much in progress. Need a blue key. Nothing to really indicate this is a blue key switch. No seagulls either. Hey! Oh. Okay then. Sure. Both sides of that should have a use. Switch thing needs some stuff on it. Even though the blue key is like. Right next to it. These were originally epilepsy tunnels with flashing lights. Quite a China didn't do that. Thank you. How could he have played this before anyway? This is the first. This has not been released or winked anywhere. Unless you've been having other people play test us, of course. I don't know why I even picked that up, to be honest. Boy, this goes on for a bit, doesn't it? Your Wi-Fi is going bonkers off the walls. See you later, chain gunner, I guess. Just disappeared into something. Ooh, height variation. With a weirdly aligned textures suddenly. Oh, that's it. I love this Wolfenstein 3DS level design here. And I think I've hit the... I think I've just explored the entire maze and I've not found an exit. This is like something you'd get in a Wolfenstein 3D level, though, honestly. Like, you really would. Oh, there's the exit. Whoa! We got glowing shit. Glowing white things. Jagged curves. Oh man. What is with these lights? must be like a passage of time effect occurring right now. Thank you for the follow, Bob Sale. How you doing? This hope you're having a good weekend. Hope everyone's having a good weekend so far. Okay, so what's the deal with these glowing lights then? What are they supposed to represent, if anything? Archfell is stuck. Very stuck. Wonder why this one has a 3 on it. 3 degrees below zero. So it's meant to be very cold, is it? These are all cold things. I can see pretty well without the lights. Like, if this is like a really dark area, yeah, sure, but it's like I can actually see everything. It just looks like some weird space. Okay, that's kind of cool. Yeah. It's almost like artsy, this. So it's something I'd expect in Bauhaus. Yeah, now in this regard, the lights work a little better. Well, except for not highlighting this particular corridor, but there's nothing here, it turns out. Also, that's an exit. But anyway, it looked actually quite nice, yeah. Zero mass and new Petonia 3. Oh, this takes me to map 5. So that area looked kind of cool. I guess if you're going for like snowy outside, that is something. Okay then, sure. There's a lot of chain gunner. So, this is E1M1. Okay, I'm in the dark. I'm in the dark again. Oh. Ugh. What is that? Drop down. But collapsed and in ruins. Okay. Very weird. And shrunk down. And missing a few rooms. Need to store the rest of your food. It's all very blue in here. Who is it? Until it's not blue anymore. I heard a spider mastermind there. And a siren even. See darkness and what? What? Okay, I guess this is very much a work in progress. Has to be. I can't imagine this is a finished level, right? Cyber, stuck spider, a bunch of weird specters. There's another one around a corner? Oh wait, there's nothing around here. Yeah, this still needs work, I feel. I'm guessing that eventually the spiders come out and there's a lot more room and general level development to occur. Yeah, I get to use the cheat because these levels clearly aren't finished yet. Also missing texture on the ceiling. So I'm going to do it to save a bit of time. What? There's no exit. Okay, fine. Map 31 is the Wolfenstein. This is just level 31 in Doom 2, isn't it? I think this is just map 31. This is edited.
True travel.
Okay, so you basically used the same level way out, but you decided my name is. Okay, you can't do that for id game stuff, and you shouldn't really be doing that in general anyway. This will not be able to go on id games because of this level. You're not allowed to just take the original level and toss in a few extra monsters. I don't even think the groups have changed that much. They seem the same to me. They're usually coming back some foreign ultra violence. As far as I could tell, anyway. Yeah. All right. Map 32. E4M1, huh? Really not a level I should be coming into from a pistol star, honestly. Wait, hold on a second. This is just E4M1. But you start from a different position. Okay, that back wall's the only difference. So all you did was just carve out a path along that wall and add a start. You also really can't do that either. That's way too much like the original E4M1. I just have to. That's the only reason I want to continue. Oh, wait a minute, this looks like my. Okay, yeah, this mess is ruined. Alright. So that was that. That's like a really. Like you said, it's a very much work in progress, so. I can't really read too much into these levels because it looks like you still got a lot of things to do with them, so. All I can say is that, yeah, you don't want to be making, you know, you can't just make an existing map from the official library and just slightly tweak it, because, one, that's against the id game's terms of service for Upworlds, and two, it's just stupid anyway. When people do stuff like that, they usually, I mean, if you want to use the original level and then add a lot more content onto it, you can do that, but when people tend to recreate the official levels, they put their own spin on it. You know, they might make something. I mean, you could essentially, if you wanted to, you could even just make the same level, but with slightly different curves and textures and enemy placements, and that would be fine. I just been to map 21. Why are we going back to map 21 again? We've covered map 21. This is it. I'm stopping here. I'm done. So, aside from the fact that a lot of textures need to be put in and a lot of fights need to be worked out and a lot of other stuff, you know, I like the idea of the glowing dark. That one glowing light room was pretty cool. And the music. It seemed okay, but I'd be curious to see how a more finished version looks like. But, yeah. What do you all think of that? Epic maps, you say, Grandpa Gaster. I mean, it's a very much a work in progress, obviously. So, you know, I tend to... Mount 21's music was okay. The music obviously is not the issue here. It's the fact that it's very... You like the harmonica. No sequels are also... Come on, people. Seriously. We're not talking about seagulls or harmonicas or planes. It's obviously still a very much a work in progress, and it very, very much shows. But... And therefore, I can't really say much. I mean... That's all I can really offer. I mean... The criticisms I would have is simply negated by the fact that this is still a work in progress, very much so. So I can't say stuff like, why are the two cyber demons in really awkward spots? Why are the spiders stuck its way? Because I've not finished the map yet, so... Yeah. Yeah, that would be a good idea. Or if you're gonna... Or, you know, I mean, are you intending to do 32 maps for this thing? Purple Nerd, is your intention to go down the full megawatt route for this? Are you going to make 32 maps or 30 maps or whatever? It seems like you are. Just curious as to your intent with this. You're going to make 32. Okay. So, 60... All right, God, no, just... Okay, no. Okay, can I suggest you don't do that? Like, seriously? Unless you're really committed, I mean, I'm not discouraging you from trying to do 32 or 64, but honestly, I've said this to other people before, especially for newer mappers, it's not really a good idea to go ahead... and make a 32 map megawatt when you're starting out as a mapper. I mean, 9 times out of 10, most people who say they're going to make a full 32 map megawatt, they don't. What they do, however, is they run into the same problem. They make some maps, they run out of ideas, and then they cancel the whole thing. And the maps that they do create sometimes just don't get ever released. Don't listen to Dave because he's senile. No, my serious suggestion would be that you don't actually try to make 32 maps. Like, 32 map megawatts are like... You know, you don't have to do that. People will have... I mean, you saw a WOD earlier where it was just 3 maps. And that was fine. 3 maps that were functional and played well. Yeah, or what Pinchy said. Because if you can't come up with 32 original ideas, because the thing is, with 32 map megawatts, while they are the de facto fashion, I don't think they are anymore. So unless it's like a community project or you're a super talented mapper, a 32 map megawatt can sometimes be a boring slog of the person just running out of ideas, because even with like good mappers, 32 map megawatts in the past, there's always a few maps that suck anyway, because it's really hard to come up with 32 original ideas and have it work for continuous and have it still be interesting. Can be done, obviously. Going Down was a good example. Good examples over the years of people who have done that by themselves, but these people are usually very good at what they're doing. You know. I mean, honestly, what I would do, Purple Nerd, is I would just try to set your target a lot lower. Like, maybe like make 5 to 10 maps and then release that, because if you're going to try and do 32 or 64, I could see you burning out and getting fed up and just not being able to complete the project. I mean, hell, just doing one good map is hard. And, you know, and I've seen over the years, a new mapper comes on, I'm going to make a 32 map megawatt, yeah! And then they get fed up and stop because they can't have come up with 32 ideas when they can barely come up with one. So our advice would be, yeah, make a couple of maps. Well, yeah, you got fed up with it because you basically committed to this idea that you want to make 32. Don't do that. Hell, make it 3 maps. If you, you know, make a map, make it really good and see if you can do more about it. If you run out of ideas, fine. Release the 2 or 3 or 4 or 5 or 6 or however many maps you've done at that point. It'd be far better if you had just a couple of well-polished maps that you actually put solid ideas into that you didn't get burnt out on, than try to push yourself for that elusive 32 map megawatt, which more than likely will be full of, well, more likely will have a lot of crap in it and it won't be appreciated, as opposed to like even just having 2 maps that are good that you spent time on and they play well. Okay, so then work on all 3 of those maps, polish them up, and who knows? Make the map, make those 3 maps better, and release it as a 3 map set. And then see what people think after that, you know? You could definitely try that. You need to add some work to all 3 of those maps, but absolutely do release them. Just those 3. And you'll be amazed that people will not mind playing a few maps. So, no, exactly. No one's tired by making a 32 map set. At all. And really, it would be nice. I mean, 32 map megawatts are not really as in fashion as they were anyway years ago, you know. People are more happier these days to play shorter map sets, and in fact, probably prefer it. You know, 32 map megawatt projects are fun, but there are, from my experience, even in ones that are decently well polished, there is always a sloggy section or a slightly dour section. 3 maps boil 0. That's even a nice title, I should say. Yeah. You know, I think new mappers definitely need to get out the habit that they have to release the megawatt straight away. You know, I think some mappers do get that now when they start out, but it'd be nice if that was like a standard rule. Don't release, make one good map first before you release 32. Or something like that. Okay. Well, I wish you the best of luck on your thing, Purple Nerd. I hope that you polish up your 3 maps and release them. And who knows, maybe in a future playtest session, when you post it on Doomworld, I might pick up on it and play the finished version. That would be nice. So, that's going to be the end of this stream. I'm just going to say let me think. Do I want to... Maybe I'll do another one. Maybe. So, as I said, no problem. So this is going to be the last sort of meaningful-ish stream for this month. I'm not going to do any more playtesting or any other wards or other games. I might do the odd WoW Classic stream for a day or two, perhaps, if I'm in the mood for it. But I'm basically going to start preparing for October, which starts in, like, 2.5 days. So I'm going to get the games set up. I'm going to make sure they run. I'm going to decide what I'm actually going to be doing. So I won't be really streaming any. I mean, I think I will stream a bit of WoW Classic after this again, because I am kind of in the mood, and also I'm in an interesting new location. But yeah, basically this is going to be the last meaningful stream for this month. Luckily the month ends soon, so it's not for very long. But yeah, a world of spooky stuff for October. I have plans to play spooky games, spooky Doom wards, and pretty much just keep up the theme for the whole month. So I'm going to plan it out a bit, and it's going to be really cool. And so because of that, I don't want to play anything now and then have it carry over in October, where I really do want to just delve into horror shit. So you might get a WoW Classic. You're going to get a WoW Classic stream after this one, and maybe tomorrow, maybe Monday even, if I feel like it. But then after that, it's horror games, horror wards, and all kinds of stuff. So, thank you to the mappers who made these maps. Thank you all for watching. I will again be doing another WoW Classic chill stream in about 15 or 20 minutes after this one ends. If you want to stick around for that, feel free. Otherwise, I will catch you all in October for spooky shit outside of the WoW Classic stuff. See you later.